Namaste, this is Meghla here from poojas.in. This video is all about Shani Dev. Like you may have watched my earlier video where I have spoken about how to befriend Shani Bhagwan and Shanishwara, the wonderful planet who rules a lot of aspects of our life and who really gives us a very hard time, especially when we are not in the path of Dharma. Shani Dasha has started. I'm totally psyched. And Ashtam Shani is going on. Sade Sati is going on. And most of them break down when they have Sade Sati. And I've spoken about different remedies and how to change our mental attitudes and befriend Shani Dev in my earlier video. So what am I doing in this video is basically I'm going to talk about one particular remedy which has really impressed me over these many years, since 2011 till now. I have suggested this remedy to various clients of mine and I have seen them progressively improve because Shani is generally very slow in his movement. So whether it is giving you a hard time or whether it is you getting good results, it takes time. He is a Vriddha. Vriddha means old. He's aged. So naturally anything, how would an aged person move around, talk? Everything is generally slowed, right? Much more than a young person, a yuvak. In the same way, Shanishwara Bhagwan, what he does is, even when he's giving you a hard time, the preparation would have started much earlier. So if you see, people who go through Sade Sati, if the Sade Sati date is on such and such a date, much before that, 2 months before, 3 months before, also people experience a lot of difficulties and challenges. And they'll start feeling that something is not okay and things like that. And then they get to know, okay, now your Sade Sati is just about to come up, it's just around the corner, which is why you're facing this kind of a challenge. So for such people, consistently doing an Abhishek every Saturday or visiting Shani temple every Saturday and praying, it becomes very hard because most of us are working or we have our own families, we have lots of things to attend to and already preset priorities. So in these kind of priorities, I know a few people who are very committed to getting rid of their problem and they will do anything possible. They will consistently visit Shani temple every Saturday and they will do Daan regularly and things like that. But at the same time, when you want to do an Abhishek, because Shani Bhagwan really loves Til Abhishek, Til Oil Abhishek, and when you want to do that, you know, it's very expensive to do it every week, every Saturday, for you to go and do it. So we devised a way of, solving this problem but through a Shani Namarchana. So a 52-week Shani Namarchana we do, which is nothing but 52 Saturdays. Every Saturday from the time you book, continuously for 52 Saturdays, we maintain a register where we make sure that every Saturday is the puja is done in your name. And Namarchana, it's a simple Namarchana. It's done in your name in a Shani temple. So we have been doing this with Tirunallar Shani Bhagwan temple. What has happened is that I have recommended this remedy since 2011 to a lot of them. And I know devotees or clients who have consistently done during their Sade Sati period for 7 years, continuously, every single year they have done the Shani Namarchana and they have progressively improved, consistently improved, slowly but surely improved. So I feel by and large, if you have these kind of phases going on in Shani Dasha, 19 years, my goodness. So don't tell me, ma'am, do we need to do it for continuous 19 years? Do it, you eat every day. So it's good and I don't know where I will be then. But what I want to tell you, it's definitely very good way to connect to Shani Bhagwan because he will see that you put your best foot forward towards him and then he will also work towards you. That is the best part of this 1 year Shani Namarchana. Otherwise also I can say that assuming there's no Shani Dasha, assuming there's no Ashtam Shani, there's no Sade Sati, nothing, you're all fine. But suddenly if you notice that there are people who have leg pain, joint pain, ankle pain, they have wounds in their leg, suddenly their leg is getting hurt, then such people also you could recommend this because it takes time to heal and anything to do with legs is again Shani Bhagwan. So it will really help them heal fast. And if you are having an ongoing court case, see that also takes time to resolve and arrive at a judgment. See all things which are connected to Shanishwara takes time. That is the nature of him. So you can't change his nature, but you can definitely change your approach towards him. Which is why I did this video, and I'm dedicating this video only for that particular puja. 52 Saturdays, every single Saturday from the time you book the puja, puja will be performed in your name and star. Namarchana will be performed in your name and star, and you will start receiving prasadam also like that regularly, because we give sankalpam there. Don't think it's just something that you do an online booking and it's done, because personally we talk to the priest and we give the sankalpam and we make sure that the puja is actually performed in your name. And if you have, like I said, if you have a court case, which is an ongoing court case, a litigation or any case, whether it's a divorce case or any property related case or whatever is going on, then you can do this. If you have any problems related to your legs, you can do this. Health, you can do it. If you have Sarasati, Ashtam, Shani and Shani Mahadasha, you can do it. Or if you just want to get his grace in gratitude and say like, my God, I know why I am what I am because of you, and you've really helped me so much sail through this difficult time. And in gratitude, if you want to do something also, it's a very good thing to do. Being active or being lazy is also governed by Shanishwara, because if you notice that, you know, there are some people who are always lazing around, who are always on the couch, who are just sleeping, or they're not interested in work. It's not like they don't have talent or skills. They do have it, but they don't want to study. They don't want to work. They just want to watch TV, laze around, even to just after their cup of coffee or tea, they don't even want to get up and go and keep it in the sink or in the kitchen or put it in the dishwasher. They don't want to wash. They don't want to do anything. Some people don't want to even have bath for ages. And mostly mothers complain about their sons like this and say, I don't know what's wrong with my son that he's always like this. He's so lazy. He's so adamant. He's so stubborn. He's just lazing around and wasting his life, his precious years, his formative years. How do I go about it? So that is all because of Shanishwara's influence. It will be his influence. So you'll have to, one thing is you can get your horoscope reading done through me, and I can recommend whether this puja is required or not. But otherwise also, what I would tell you is that you could straight away do this puja and you can start seeing good results, because he will start changing, he'll start moving. Lazy people will start becoming active. They will start gaining the Ichha Shakti or the willpower to, I want to work, I want to do something, and I want to develop some kind of an interest, and I don't want to waste my life. This is the kind of attitude they'll change to. So even if you feel that in your neighborhood, in your family, if you see somebody very lazy, you could recommend this puja for him or her, and it will really help them get out of their lazy couch. Consistently approaching him every single Saturday of the year, through your name, through your star, through your Gotra, is really a fantastic thing to do. And you can see that he will start blessing you through a lot of boons, I can say, because he'll start making those amends in your life, you know, amendments in your life, small changes in your life. So much so that you don't go the karmic route and you go the dharmic route. And not just being dharmic or karmic, it's also about you not doing more of negative karma again. That is very important, because what you do now decides your next life or your life little later than what it is now. So it's Kali Yuga. Remember, many times I see people get punished instantly for what they have done, wrong things they have done. And some people take time, but when they are hit, they are not able to get up at all. So this is one more thing I can say. And if your nakshatra is Anuradha nakshatra, if it's Pushya nakshatra, also you can get it done. So Anuradha, Pushya and Uttarabhadra, these are the three Shani nakshatras. So you want to get empowered by Shanishwara, and you want him to really boost you further. And if you belong to Makar Rashi, any of the nakshatras which are governed under the Makar Rashi, then also you can do these. I mean, I can go on listing and I can give you 100 reasons why you should do this. 100 different kinds of situations where you do this kind of a puja to get good results. See, Makar Rashi is governed by him, Kumbh Rashi is governed by Shani. So both the Rashi people can get it done. At the same time, all the three Shani nakshatras, you can get it done. Then if Shani is your Rogadipati, you get it done. If Shani is your Vyajadipati, the 12th house lord, you get it done. Like that, I can go on listing, but that's not the point. The point here is not that I'm trying to sell you a great idea of a puja for poojas.in, but the point is, how do you reduce your misery? How on earth can you appease Shanishwara, how can you befriend him in a consistent way? See, for example, let's apply common sense here. So you have an acquaintance with a person, and the more and more you meet that person for lunch, for dinner, or you invite that person home, or you go to their house, things change, the chemistry changes, and automatically you feel like, I think I like this person, I'm getting to know him better, and things like that. In the same way, you do one Abhisheka now, one Shani Shanti Homa a little later, maybe after 6 months, and then nothing. What will be the chemistry between you and Shanishwara? Think about it. That is exactly what I'm trying to tell you. So if you want to have an ongoing chemistry with him in a way that consistently he thinks about you as much as you need it, then automatically this particular puja will help you that consistently. And what you need to do is, once we send you the prasad, consistently every single day, you can apply the kumkum and the vibhuti on your forehead or here, on your neck or your chest. These three places you can apply, or any one of them you can apply, and you can start your day. And once you come back home, you can refresh yourself, have a shower or wash your face, or whatever is your normal procedure of refreshing. You can do that, sip your coffee and all, and just apply this and be relaxed. You see how things will change. The whole scenario will change for the better. And this is something that I wanted to tell you, because a lot of them have got benefit, and a lot of them are still continuing to do this even after they have their worst phase is over, because they feel it's really worth being connected to Shanishwara in this manner. So if you feel you want to do this puja, you can WhatsApp me or you can call me, you can talk to me about this, and we will have it arranged for you, for your name, for your star and your gotra. Okay, so I wish you all the best, and I really look forward to hearing from a lot of you who have watched this video to go for this particular puja. It's called 1 year Shani Namarchana, or the 52 Saturdays Shani Namarchana Puja. All the best. Jai Shani Dev, Jai Shanishwara Bhagwan. Pranam.